What's going on, boys? My name is Hoax. We're doing True Alpha Scott McCall versus Hybrid Jackson Whitmore. This fantasy fight is pretty interesting because Jackson, of course, is part quote-unquote Kenema, and he's pretty versatile when it comes to abilities. But yeah, leave a like and subscribe. Before we begin, I want you guys to go down below and comment who you think is going to win this fantasy fight. Then at the end of the video, I want to see if you're right. If you are right, I'll heart your comment. But without further ado, let's begin. Starting off with strength, this very clearly goes to Scott McCall. Yes, Jackson is a hybrid, but we never actually saw him have that Kenema strength as he did in season 2, so I can't really draw any feats from season 2 Jackson because he was full Kenema. I can only go from season 6 and upwards, and we have more strength feats from Scott McCall. I do think Jackson is strong as a werewolf, but ultimately I do think Alpha Scott McCall is stronger. Wolf, Jackson is an Omega werewolf with Kenema abilities, but because he is an Omega, he won't have that strength boost that Alpha Scott does. That is just a fact. Yes, Jackson is strong, although we don't have any feats from him in terms of strength. We can only just speculate because he is part Kenema. I still believe that Alpha Scott would significantly be stronger than Jackson Whitmore. Even as a beta, Scott McCall was almost on par with Jackson as a Kenema, which being an alpha and Jackson now being a werewolf, one lowered, one got higher in terms of strength. Clearly Scott McCall got higher and Jackson got lower. There's a scene that isn't talked about in terms of Scott McCall's strength, but it's actually in season 3B. I think this scene is actually pretty cool in terms of strength. He basically runs up and grabs Ethan and Aiden, throws Ethan, and then outroars Aiden. Now, mind you, Scott McCall picked Ethan up with one hand and tossed him pretty far and threw him into a wall, which I think is very impressive. Mind you, Ethan would weigh around 70 to 90 kilos, which I think is very impressive as well, that people don't really talk about these small scenes of Scott showcasing his strength. Another strength feat I have to talk about as well is when he fought the Beast of Javadan. He fought him twice and actually held his own pretty well. Even in the Beast bestial form, that's like a tongue twister to say, he was going toe-to-toe with him, which would just, in general, power scale Scott McCall higher than Jackson in terms of strength, so I don't think Jackson could go toe-to-toe with the Beast like that. And the Beast himself, Sebastian Vallée, even quoted Scott McCall of having good amount of strength. There is no doubt about that. But yeah, strength very clearly goes to Scott McCall. Moving on to speed, this has to go to Scott McCall again. We have no speed feats from Jackson, only when he was a Kenema. And even then, he was kind of on par as a werewolf in terms of speed. It was really Jackson's Kenema agility that really made him superior to werewolves in terms of speed. As a normal werewolf slash Kenema, but he again is a werewolf with Kenema abilities, I definitely have to go with Scott McCall in terms of speed. In season 3, he was able to keep up with Malia, which by the way, a coyote's top speed is 60 k's an hour, given that Malia is a were coyote. We could only assume she was going faster than that, but yeah, he was able to keep up with her to a steady degree. I'm not saying Jackson isn't fast, he could be fast, but there is no speed feats to really go off apart from when he was a Kenema, and as a Kenema, he was fairly on par with werewolves in terms of speed. He could definitely be agile, of course he could, but speed genuinely has to go to Scott McCall in my personal opinion. Moving on to agility, this one again is mixed. I'm gonna give it to adult Scott McCall. Jackson in terms of fighting was always more of a brawler as a werewolf, while Scott McCall was always focused on flips and kicks and all different range of movements. As a Kenema, again, the agility would definitely go to Jackson Whitmore, but we're not talking about a Kenema at the moment, we're talking about his werewolf form. Agility definitely goes to Scott McCall. His fight against Deucalion when he was a beta, and even when the hunters came after him in season 4, Scott McCall was seen kicking ass again. Even at one point where he almost had killing intent, you could say, Scott McCall was physically going ham on everybody. But yeah, moving on to combat, and if you made it this far, I'm sure you're already thinking, well, bro, Jackson can clearly use his paralytic venom against Scott McCall and bam, he wins. Just no. Hear me out. When Scott McCall fought Tracy, he was able to grab her hands before she physically was able to stab him.
Sucks, doesn't it?
I'm almost positive as an experienced alpha. You have to remember that fight was in season 5A. Scott McCall now being in season 6B, I'm talking about teen Scott, not adult Scott here, was able to catch her hand before she was able to stab him. Scott McCall would not only be more experienced in combat at that point after fighting Garrett Douglas and Monroe and the Hunters, also the Beast of Javadan, I don't think it's possible for Jackson to even lay a hand on Scott McCall, let alone paralyze him. Also again, Jackson is a brawler. We saw this in his return fight in Wolves of London. I think that's the episode, season 6, episode 17. He was literally getting his ass kicked by a woman. Not being sexist or anything, if he was human, he would have lost that fight. That girl had him in a triangle choke. Jackson just outstrength her, which isn't a really big deal because he is a Kanemo slash werewolf hybrid. And before that, he clearly got his ass kicked by her and the other guy because he was captured by them. Their mistake was using regular wolfsbane on him. I just think Jackson, when it comes to combat, is an experience as Scott, more of a brawler. And people always go, well, Scott McCall's also a brawler. He's just not. I can show many times of where he has good martial art understanding, like in his fight against Kate Argent, who was a trained werewolf killer, while in his base form, he was doing capoeira moves against her. But yeah, combat definitely goes to Scott McCall here. Moving on to durability, this one again goes to Scott McCall. While Scott McCall has a good tolerance towards electricity, while on the other hand, Jackson doesn't. Scott McCall is able to pick up an overcharged Kira in season 5. And of course, in season 4, was able to break free from the Calaveras' top electricity setting.
Can you get turned by scratch?
Not if the claws go deep enough.
Not to mention all the other times where Scott McCall has been durable, like when he fought the Beast of Javadan, or even when he got shot in season 4. The dude is physically more durable than Jackson is, and if anything, the team of the movie just solidifies that even more. Jackson got shot in the foot and waited there, he did nothing at all.
Fights to some demented druid.
I was in London for all of that.
The dude did not heal or do anything. He got shot in the foot and just sat down. Meanwhile, Scott McCall got shot in the shoulder and just kept on moving.
The others back, tell them to hide. Kira!
Durability definitely goes to Scott McCall by a landslide. Moving on to IQ, I think Jackson is one of the most dumbest characters in the show. Not really like dumb, I just think he isn't as smart as everyone else. He's common sense smart, but in terms of literal smartness, he's pretty dumb. Like when he got captured by Monroe, someone he never knew before. Like, let me put in some context right here. He came back to Beacon Hills because he knows Gerard Argent is after him and has a bunch of werewolf hunters looking for him. Walks through the Beacon Hills High School to find Scott McCall and sees this random woman he has never seen in his whole entire life, and willingly follows her, knowing that there are known hunters out there because of Gerard Argent, and Gerard Argent has multiple connections throughout Beacon Hills. Does anyone else think that's just a tad bit dumb? Because I definitely do. Then he has the audacity to say, well, I thought it was a lacrosse thing. Like, even Ethan knows that stupidity was just right there. But yeah, it's self-explanatory. IQ goes to Scott McCall. I can already talk about his two biggest feats in terms of IQ. That was outsmarting Derek, Gerard, and of course, Deucalion.
I had a plan too.
Mountain Ash!
But yeah, IQ definitely goes to Scott McCall. Moving on to power, it's self-explanatory again. Scott McCall is a true alpha. He also broke Mountain Ash in season 3B, which takes an extreme amount of power. It almost killed him. But yeah, it's pretty obvious power goes to Scott McCall. And I feel this leaves the clear winner being Scott McCall by a landslide. I think Jackson, I see Scott McCall beating Jackson so effortlessly, dude. And I don't see an argument saying he doesn't. You have to remember when he became a werewolf in season 2, he lost a lot of that kind of strength, speed, durability, etc., and became just a weak werewolf. So weak that he couldn't even heal in Teen Wolf the movie. But yeah, that's my thoughts and opinions. I think Scott McCall wins this easy difficulty. Let me know your thoughts down below in the comments section. Make sure to join my Discord server link down below in the description. It's been your boy Hoax, and you guys are watching, and it's about it. See ya.